Here, most of the dwarf elements take only dwarf elements. Most of the dwarf elements or main compounds or main compounds. Most of the dwarf elements will be compound exhibit color. Exhibit color. Most of them, except a few, either cadmium plus three or zinc salts are colorless. But remaining all the compounds of dwarf elements are not exhibiting color. Due to different reasons, presence of unpaired electrons in d orbitals, presence of unpaired electrons in d orbitals, incompletely filled d orbital. Unpaired electrons in d orbitals, incompletely filled d orbital. Second reason is it is due to d orbital electronic transitions. D orbital electronic transitions. D to d electronic transition. What is this? D orbital to d orbital electronic transitions. Here, according to a theory known as crystal field theory, this theory we will discuss in the next class, next lesson, that is complex compound. According to crystal field theory, this 5d orbitals under the influence of different field strengths of the ligands, suppose it may be a cyanide ligand, a chloride ligand, a amine ligand. Those particular 5d orbitals are degenerate when a ligand is approaching toward this particular d orbital. That may be chloride ligand, cyanide ligand, amine ligand. Any ligand is actually reaching or nearing to this particular d orbital. The 5d orbitals split into different energy levels. 5d orbitals split into different energy levels. Under the influence of this particular, the different fields of the ligand, this particular 5d orbitals split into different energy levels. That is what higher energy level, this is what a E.T. set of orbitals. And lower energy level, this is what a T2D set of orbitals. Now, this is what a DXY, DXZ, this is now DYZ. The lower energy orbitals are T2D, DXZ, YZ, XY. The higher energy level, this is what a px square minus y square and dz square is what a E.T. set of orbital. The 5d orbitals under the influence of different field strength of the ligand, the 5d orbitals split into different energy levels, lower energy level d to d, higher energy level e.t. The energy difference between these two orbitals is very less. This is dependent by delta. This is octet. In octet geometry, this is the splitting. The 5d orbitals splitting like this. Therefore, we call it as what now? Delta O. O stands for octet. Delta stands for energy difference. O stands for octet. In octet geometry, the 5d orbitals are splitting like this. The detailed discussion will be there in the next lesson. At present, to remember like this. Next step. Now, after the splitting, the electrons are entering into lower energy level like this. Then, energy difference between these two d orbitals, T2D and dz, is not very less. It is equal to visible region of light, Therefore, for electronic transition between these two d orbitals absorbing from visible region, X color is absorbed, this electron is getting excited. Once electron is getting excited, in the higher energy level, the electron is not stable. Therefore, it is getting de-excited. So, excitation and again de-excitation. This is continuously taking place equivalent to velocity flight. This particular transition, what you call D2D transition, both are d orbitals only. Therefore, d orbital to d orbital electronic transition. Specifically, in octet geometry, this is what to say T2D2 EG electronic transitions. Were they absorbing X color? Why the excitation? It is transmitting what are Y color. X is absorbed, Y transmitted. Whatever the color it is transmitting, that is the color of the compound. Therefore, color of the compound. Therefore, this particular transfer what to call D2 EG you say, or d orbital to b orbital electronic transition. So most of the d block elements in their compound activity are due to this reason: unpaired electrons, incomplete filled d orbital to b orbital electronic transition. Specifically, in octal geometry, T2D2PD electronic transitions. Over. Next, on the next point. The D0 and D10, D0 and D10 electronic configurations are found to be analogous. So, D0 means no electronic D orbital. When there is no electron, no transition, no absorption, no emission, no color. D0 is what color is? D10. D10 means for, it is there in fully filled 6 electrons, it is gaining fully filled 4 electrons. Lower energy orbital, lower energy, higher energy. Both are carrying full orbital, fulfilled orbital. There is no chance for transition. No chance for transition. Therefore, again, there is no DD transition. No absorption, no emission. Therefore, what I am saying, D0 and D10 electronic configurations are found to be colorless. Zinc plus 2, D10, colorless. All the zinc compounds are colorless. Scandium plus 3, D0, colorless. And again, you can take this one, D0 and D10. Let me use the example one, D0. All scandium plus 3 cells or titanium plus 4 cells, colorless. Coming to D10, D10, copper plus 1, D10 no, colorless. And again, zinc plus 2, colorless. Aluminium, come on, plus 2. So, scandium plus 3, titanium plus 4, copper plus 1, zinc plus 2, cadmium plus 2, compound. Generally, zinc, cadmium, copper plus 1 salts are colorless, and scandium compounds, titanium plus 4 compounds are generally found to be colorless. Right. One more point to see. Even though D0 configuration, some of the compounds are exhibiting color. Even though D0 configuration, suppose we collect KMnO4, see the word. KMnO4. K2CR2O7, let's say B2O5. Come on, but also the manganese, come on. What is the manganese?
7, sir. 7.
But also the chromium, come on.
Plus 6.
Plus 6. But also the beryllium, come on, first.
Plus 4, sir.
Plus 5. Okay. Plus 5. Now, what is the configuration remaining in Mn plus 7? What is the configuration in Mn plus 7?
The D1.
D0. Mn plus 7 or D0?
D0.
Mn plus 7 configuration, what is it?
Yes, sir. D0.
What is it? What is it? Mn plus 7, what is the remaining configuration?
D0, sir.
D0 is
0. D0 is 0. Chromium plus. Let's say, what is the remaining configuration?
D0, sir.
D0, S0. B plus 1 day?
D0, sir.
D0. Pine in Japan, no? D0 found any colorless in Japan. D0 found any colorless in Japan. Whether these should be colorless or colored?
Colorless.
Colorless.
Colorless. According to our discussion, according to my discussion, whatever I said to you, they should be colorless. But KMnO4 is colored or not?
Colored, sir.
What is the color? Don't know. Purple. Dark purple in color. KMnO4. What is the color of K2CR2O7? Colored or not? Don't know.
Orange.
K2CR2O7 is orange color. Dark orange in color. V2O5 in solution, V2O5 light yellow in color. Light yellow in color. But we are saying, according to our discussion, D0 configuration should not exhibit color. But we know KMnO4 is colored, K2CR2O7 is colored, V2O5 is also colored. Why they are exhibiting color even though D0 configuration? This is due to anybody? This is due to, right? This is due to charge transfer phenomenon. Very, very important. Every year this is the question. Charge transfer phenomenon. Even though D0 configuration, KMnO4, K2CR2O7, V2O5 should not exhibit color. but they are exhibiting color. This is due to what reason? Come on, all of you say, what reason?
Charge transfer phenomenon.
Charge transfer is a very, very important term. This term will appear every year in exam. Right? So what is actually charge transfer? What is actually charge transfer? See, here Mn2O, no? Mn plus 7 is oxide. No, Mn plus 7 is oxide. Mn plus 7 is oxide. This is what metal, this is what ligand. Metal, ligand. Metal to ligand, ligand to metal always. Electron charge transfer takes place. Electron charge transfer takes place. This particular charge transfer absorbing visible region of light. Absorbing visible region of light. Therefore, they are exhibiting color. Therefore, they are exhibiting color. Any substance absorbing visible region that will be exhibiting color. So, metal to ligand, this is a ligand in the metal. Metal to ligand, ligand to metal, always electron charge transfer takes place. Due to this particular phenomenon, suppose oxygen is transferring an electron to this one, it is becoming plus 6, it is becoming what, O minus. Okay, very next moment, it is actually losing an electron, then it is becoming again plus 7, it is becoming what, R, minus. Like this, metal to ligand, ligand to metal, metal to ligand, ligand to metal, always continuously charge transfer taking place. For this particular charge transfer, absorbing visible region of light, any substance absorbing visible region of light that will be exhibiting color. Therefore, KMnO4, K2Cr2S, and V2O5, even though V0 configuration exhibiting color, this is due to what? Come on.
Charge transfer
phenomenon.
Again, there is different types of charge transfers are there. Often it may be metal to ligand, or it may be ligand to metal. Types of charge transfer we see, there is no place on the board. Next point we discuss, types of charge transfers. Take the notes first. Most of the D block elements. In their compounds. Exhibit color. This is due to. Come on, due to A, come on. Okay. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Right, yes, sir.
Presence of unpaired electrons in d orbitals. Unpaired electrons in d orbitals are incompletely filled d orbitals. Incompletely filled d orbitals. B. Come on, due to A, you are written. Come on, B. 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 D orbital to D orbital electron in transition. D orbital to D orbital electronic transition. Electronic transition in the bracket. D to EG electronic transitions. D to EG electronic transitions. Right. So these are the regions 1 and 2. Limit. Come to the next point. AB over. Next point separately. D0. Write this one. D0. Write this. D0. Scandium plus 3, scandium plus 4. D10. Copper plus 1, zinc plus 2, Cd plus 2. D10. 3D plus 2 are found to be colorless. 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 Next slide. Ready, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Right. K-4. A to CR to O7. V to O5. V to O5. Even though D0 electronic configuration, exhibit color. Due to charge transfer phenomenon. Next. Types of charge transfers. Types of charge transfers. Look here. K-4. K2 CR to O7. CRO to CL2. Cerium sulfate. Hemoglobin. Brown ring complex. Persian blue complex. Persian blue complex. See the board for a while. Okay, don't write. Are you completed this one all? Completed?
Yes, sir.
Say something.
Yes, sir.
Good or not? Come on.
Completed, yes, sir.
Loudly, voice is very nice. Good here. You have to check it, whether it is from metal to ligand, ligand to metal, we have to check it. Now, so here, this is the metal ligand. These two are the ligand, this is the metal ligand. Hemoglobin, you know hemoglobin? Hemoglobin, iron actually plus 2. Right, in hemoglobin iron is plus 2. Brown ring, this is the brown ring complex. See the board. Fe, H2O, D5, ELO. ELO. This is what SO4. In this, I am what plus one, m by what a plus. Question group. This is Fe4, Fe, Cl3+6, different types. Outside I have 3, inside I have 2. This one. Question. Look here, come to this particular KMnO4. Come on, say, what is the oxygen of manganese? What is the oxygen of manganese?
Plus 7.
We got oxide. O is -2, Mn is what? +1. Is Mn is carrying any electron to transfer or not? All of you. Is Mn is carrying any electron to transfer or not?
No, sir.
Therefore, there is no transfer of electron from metal. Compulsory ligand has to transfer. Ligand has to transfer. So what transfer I can consider here? Come on, all of you. Ligand to metal charge transfer. Ligand to metal. This is ligand to metal charge transfer. Come on. What is the oxygen number of chromium here? All of you, come on.
+6.
What is the oxygen of chromium?
+6.
Is it carrying any electron now? No.
No, sir.
Can it transfer? No. Come on. Which has to transfer electron? Come on.
Ligand
to metal charge transfer. Coming to this. Yes. Number of this one. Come on, all of you.
+6.
Is it carrying any electron? No. Can it transfer? No. Therefore, compulsory again. Ligand to metal charge transfer. Ligand to metal charge transfer. You want to say CrO2 Cl2. Do you know what is the name of CrO2 Cl2? Anybody? Do you know the name of CrO2 Cl2?
Chromyl chloride.
Correct only.
Chromyl chloride.
Good, chromyl chloride. What is the oxygen number of chromium?
+2.
What is the oxygen number of chromium?
+6.
Plus six. As it is carrying any electron now, no chance. Therefore, again, it is also from ligand to metal. Either it will be chlorine or it will be oxygen. Come on, cerium sulfate. What is oxygen or cerium? Come on.
Plus four.
Cerium is the first element, you see. Cerium is the first element in lanthanides. Okay. It's electronic on F1D1S2. F1D1S2. 4 electrons are there. We're losing all the 4 electrons. There is no electron in cerium. They were compulsory from, come on, say.
Ligand to metal.
Coming to this particular, hemoglobin. Do you know structure of hemoglobin? No? Anything about hemoglobin you know? No. Leave it. Good. Now, it is hemoglobin is iron plus 2 day, porphyrin ring day. Very big ligand day. We'll discuss hemoglobin structure, myoglobin structure, chlorophyll structure, vitamin B12 structure. I'll discuss. Due to all these structures, just wait. Next, you see, this hemoglobin is what? Iron plus 2, porphyrin, porphyrin ring, porphyrin ring. This is the ligand. This is what hemoglobin molecule, iron plus 2, and porphyrin. Iron plus 2 is the surrounding this, a big ligand is the ring is the. That ring is what you call ligand, that ligand what you call porphyrin ring, porphyrin ring. Now, here, Fe plus 2 is actually losing 2 electrons. It is not sufficient number of electrons. Not carrying sufficient number of electrons. It is lost electrons. Then it cannot easily donate a pair of electrons or transfer. Again, it is also, again, ligand to metal only, porphyrin to metal. So, ligand to metal charge transfer. Ligand to metal charge transfer. Metal charge transfer. Next, here grounding complex. You see, grounding complex. I mentioned once in grounding complex, even fifth group I mentioned once, grounding complex and all. Here, Fe plus. What is the configuration of Fe plus? Come on, all of you. Fe plus. Configuration of Fe plus. So it is sufficient electrons or deficient electron generally?
Sir, sufficient to donate.
It is losing only one electron. Let to be from s orbital it is losing. It is not losing all the two electrons from s orbital. S orbital is also carrying electron. It is sufficient number of electrons. Moreover, H2O cannot transfer an electron. There is no charge. NO. NO in this is what? Nitrous helium. NO plus. Now, NO plus, NO is carrying actually 15. The 15th electron is lost. Whether NO is electron deficient or sufficient now? NO plus?
Deficient, sir.
Deficient. It is not deficient, but it is deficient. Therefore, compulsory charge transfer from
metal to ligand.
Remember, in rounding complex, the charge transfer is from metal to ligand. Remember, Fe plus 1 is not that much electron deficient. It is D6S2. Only one electron is lost. Still, it is carrying 7 electrons in it. One point. Second point, NO. If NO is Fe, NO is carrying 1 electron, 15th electron in the 15th electron. It lost 1 electron. So, NO is in the form of plus. So, it is what electron deficient, more it is carrying plus charge. Once it is positive charge, then it transfer electron, there is no charge. Therefore, compulsory metal has to transfer electron to NO plus. In brown ring, the brown color is. In brown ring, the brown color is due to charge transfer. The charge transfer is from metal to ligand.
Metal to ligand.
Metal to ligand. In this, the charge transfer is actually metal to ligand. Metal to ligand. Next, Prussian blue. If you don't know what is Prussian blue, is what dark blue colored compound thing. Dark blue colored complex. That is what Fe4FeCl6 taken right. Is what you say Prussian blue, right? Outside one metal is there, inside one metal is there. Without the participation of this particular ligand, always electron transfer takes from outside the sphere to inside the sphere, to metal. In this metal to metal. Charge transfer takes place, therefore it looks like what are or green color. This is what metal to metal. See, metal to metal charge transfer. This is dark green color. So these are the types of charge transfer. Types of charge transfer. Take it as it is. Come on, as it is. Types of charge transfers, very very important. K manifold has appeared till now. K manifold expression. The color of K manifold due to charge transfer. And what type of charge transfer? Metal to ligand, ligand to metal, metal to metal, all like this. Take. Completed, come on, all of you. The completed, say completed. Then we'll start next time. Ready?
Completed, sir.
Completed.
Sir, completed, sir.
Right, good. Come on, next. Look here, next. Color property depend on the following factors. Come on, color properties. Depend on. The following factors. color property depend on the following factors. Depend on the following factors. One. Mr. Gore, it is dependent on the number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electrons in d orbitals are number of see the word, number of incompletely filled d orbitals. Incompletely filled d orbitals. Number of unpaired electrons in d orbitals. A number of incompletely filled d orbitals. See the board. What is this? Now, so taking CuCl2 for example, NiCl. Okay, one is CuCl2. Second one is NiCl2. CuCl2 and NiCl2. What is the oxygen number of copper? Is what +2. Yes. What oxygen number of copper is what +2. What is the configuration of copper +2? Come on,
3d9 sir.
D9. Nickel +2, come on.
D8, sir.
D8.
How many unpaired electrons?
1, sir.
1.
How many unpaired electrons?
0.
2.
2. 2, sir. 2, sir.
2. How many incomplete d orbitals?
1, sir.
1.
How many incomplete d orbitals?
2.
Incomplete d orbitals 2, incomplete d orbitals 1, like this. Now, CuCl2 and NaCl2, okay? Both are having what? +2 +2 oxygen state. Both are looking alike, but their colors are different. Why? This is having one unpaired electron, two unpaired electron. One incomplete filled d orbital, two incomplete filled d orbital. Therefore, color property dependent on what? Number of unpaired electrons and number of incompletely filled d orbitals. Therefore, CuCl2 and NaCl2 are not having identical colors. They are having different colors. Next one. You know, you see, color property depend on nature of the ligands. You see, nature of the ligands. Nature of the ligands. That means what? Ligands are, ligand, you know, electron pair donor. But I said once, ligands are different types. By accepting ligands, I said no. Ligands are different types. In this particular ligands, some are strong field ligands, some are weak field ligands. Which are easily donating, they are strong field. Which cannot easily donate, they are what? Weak field. So strong field and again weak field ligands, two types of ligands are there. Two types of ligands. So color property depend on nature of the ligand. Nature of the ligand. Suppose, see, I am giving some examples. Tu, H2O taken 4, H2O taken 4 plus 2. This I am substituting by NS3. The Cu, NS3 taken 4, NS3 taken 4 plus 2. This I am substituting by Cl minus. And Cu Cl4 minus 2. Cl4 minus 2. Here aqua ligand. Ligand is what? Water molecule. Ligand is the ammonia molecule. Ligand is what? Chloride. But in all these, +2, +2, +2. Copper is +2 in all these. Copper is D9 in all these. Everything is okay. But what is different is the water molecule the ligand, ammonia the ligand, chloride the ligand. Once ligand is changing, nature of the ligand is changing, color is also changing. This will remember light green color. This is dark green color. Light green color, dark green color. Remember, this is yellow in color. So, when the ligand is changing, color is changing. Color power dependent on nature of the ligand. It is forming a bond. Next one, third one. Dependent on geometry, remember. Dependent on geometry. Geometry. For example, see, nickel +2. You know, what is the configuration? D8. A nickel +2 metal ion, a nickel +2 metal ion can form different complexes with different geometries. It can form a tetrahedral complex. It can form a tetrahedral complex, a space phenol complex, or it can also form an octahedral complex. It can form a tetrahedral complex, it can form a space phenol complex, it can form an octahedral complex. But come on, check. In all these, what is the metal ion? What is the metal ion?
Nickel.
Nickel plus. What is the configuration?
D8.
In all these, metal ion is nickel plus 2. Configuration also D8. But once same metal ion, same configuration, they should exhibit same color. Once geometry is changing, color is also changing. This is having X color, this is having Y color, this is having Z color. It's surprise the same. Metal ion is same, configuration is same, and but electrons are same, everything is same. But the color is different. The color is different because of what reason?
Shape change.
Geometry. Geometry changing, color is also changing. So color property also dependent on what factor? Come on, all of you.
Geometry.
Right? Nature of the ligand and the geometry of the complex. Provided the metal ion is same oxidation number, same configuration. Once it is forming different complex, the different geometries, geometry also influence the color property. Right? There is so much there to discuss. Right on. Color property depend on the following factors. Right? First one. Number of unpaired electrons in d orbitals. Number of unpaired electrons in d orbitals or number of incompletely filled d orbitals. Second one. Nature of the ligand. Second one. Nature of the ligands. Take it. Light blue. Dark blue. Green. Light blue, dark blue, green. Dark blue, green. Not green, it's yellow, sorry. It's yellow, not green. Next, third factor, geometry. Geometry. As in the red, nickel plus 2 D8. Nickel plus 2 D8. Tetradal, tailpanol, octadal. Tetradal, tailpanol, octadal. X color, Y color, Z color. Nickel plus 2 D8, tetradal X color, tetradal Y color, octadal Z color. So these are the factors influencing the color properties. Next. There is a relation between absorbed and transmitted colors. The relation between absorbed and transmitted colors. For example, absorbed color, transmitted color. For example, absorbed color, and transmitted color. There is a relation between absorbed and transmitted colors. Transmitted colors. Now, If X current absorbed, Y color is transmitted. If Y is absorbed, come on, X is transmitted. If orange is absorbed, blue is transmitted. Come on, blue is absorbed, orange is transmitted. These pairs of colors, what to call? These complementary colors we call. This thing, XY, orange, blue, this pairs of colors, what to call? Complementary colors, remember. Complementary colors. Next, one more point. So I here make a table. Complete visual identity, VGR. Complete VGR I am writing on the board. And I will make a table. What color is absorbed? What color is transmitted? What is the relationship between? What is the importance of this particular relationship and all? I will discuss just a minute. Next, one more point I am going to. The color property is due to charge transfer phenomenon. Color property due to charge transfer phenomenon. Charge transfer phenomenon generally found to be dark. Color property due to charge transfer phenomenon generally found to be dark. I hope you know potassium permanganate. Did you see the color of potassium permanganate? Potassium permanganate color chusara meeru andaru. Potassium permanganate color meeku telusa tarvata eppudu chusara leda?
No sir, we don't.
Chusara?
No sir.
Potassium permanganate?
Mm-hmm. No sir.
Purple.
You know or don't know?
Sir, pinkish.
Pinkish color. Purple.
Dark purple color, sir.
Cheti kandu kuda attane untadi. Cheti kandu kuda attane untadi. Sabbu vetna podadi. Right? So, K104. Potassium permanganate is what dark purple in color. Not only potassium permanganate. Generally, wherever you see, in general, there may be one or two exceptions, but most of them. Wherever color property due to charge transfer phenomenon, they are found to be dark, intense in color. Intense. Why? The color properties due to charge transfer phenomenon are dark or intense. Dark colors. Right? This is due to these color charge transfer transitions. Color charge transfer transitions or Laporte forbidden transitions. Laporte forbidden transitions. Forbidden transition, not allowed transitions. Just to remember the word. The color body to charge transfer phenomenon are dark because this charge transfer transitions are Laporte forbidden transitions. Laporte forbidden. Just remember, there is a large explanation in the body Laporte forbidden, Laporte allowed. Next. Color body due to DD transitions. DD transitions generally found to be light colors. There may be exceptions, but not two, but most of them in general, color properties due to DD transitions are found to be light colors because these are Laporte allowed transitions. Laporte allowed transition. So DD transitions are allowed transitions, therefore light, and this charge transfer transition not allowed transition, therefore they are what? Dark in color. Then we'll make a table now that what are the absorbed colors? What are the transmitted colors? What are the relationship between these? Right? Come on. Right about. There is a relationship between absorbed and transmitted colors. Absorbed and transmitted colors. Absorbed and transmitted colors. The pairs of colors are known as complementary colors. Come on, Flo. Let's make this complementary. PLE, complementary, don't write LI. LI is complement, that is different. Tuba function, that is. It is complementary, related to complementary. Right. Come on, write all of you, whatever way I am writing. VGR, write all of you first. VIV, G, Y, O, R, infrared. All of write like this first. Complementary colors, VGR. See, I am giving the numbering here. Take the numbering like this. Infrared, red, orange, yellow, orange, yellow, yellow green, yellow green, 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 blue green, blue green, blue, indigo, violet. Infrared, red, orange, yellow, yellow green, green, blue green, blue, blue green, blue, indigo, violet.
This is what are the absorbed colors. Same order I am writing absorbed colors. Come on, man. Put the numeric carefully and write it. Observed, transmitted.
Infrared, red, orange, orange, yellow, yellow green, green, blue green, yellow green, green, blue green, blue, indigo, visible or not visible, indigo, violet, indigo, violet. Here I am doing the MRA, see, blue green, blue, indigo, violet. Indigo, violet. Here is the MRA, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to violet. Below violet you write UV. Below violet also you write UV. Here also is the name. After violet UV day, after violet UV right, below violet you write UV also, yeah. Right, now, come on, say all of you, if infrared is absorbed, what is the color we can expect? Infrared is absorbed, what is the color we can expect? Come on, all of you. Infrared is absorbed, what is the color you can expect? Come on.
UV, sir, probably. UV.
UV. If infrared is absorbed, what color you can expect?
Don't know, sir.
Don't know. Limit. Infrared is actually invisible, is it not? This is invisible, this is visible, is on this much only. If invisible is absorbed, invisible only transmitted. Invisible is absorbed, invisible only transmitted, therefore colorless. Infrared absorbed, colorless. Come on, right on, colorless. Come on, take red, blue, green.
Red, blue, green. Orange, orange, blue. Orange, blue. Yellow, indigo. Yellow, indigo. Yellow green, violet. Green, pink. Green, pink. This is separate color. Then.
This is complementary, you know. Complementary, you know. Absorbed and transmitted. Come on. If blue green is absorbed, come on.
Red, red,
red.
Huh?
Red, red.
Blue, green, red, blue, orange, blue, orange, indigo, yellow, indigo, yellow, violet, yellow, green, yellow, green.
UV, come on, what is the color? UV?
Colorless.
Colorless.
UV.
Colorless, sir.
Ah, colorless. Invisible. Come on, sir, all of you. Come on, sir, all of you. From this particular table, what you got the point, what you actually follow, all of you? Ah. But actually you followed. Complementary colors we are following, one point. Second point, you see carefully. The color from longer wavelength is absorbed. Color from longer wavelength is absorbed. Color from shorter wavelength is transmitted and vice versa. A color from longer wavelength is absorbed. Color from shorter wavelength is transmitted. See, suppose red, it is what? Longer wavelength. And blue-green, longer wavelength absorbed, shorter wavelength transmitted. Suppose violet and again yellow, shorter is absorbed, longer is transmitted. That's the actual concept we are understanding on this particular table. Write a point. From the above table, we can say that a color from longer wavelength region is absorbed. A color from longer wavelength region is absorbed. Longer wavelength region is absorbed. A color from shorter wavelength region is transmitted. Shorter wavelength region is transmitted. And vice versa. Transmitted and vice versa. Vice versa. There are actually mixed colors are there in this. Mixed colors are there. Yellow, green, green, like that. Right? So let us make it a prominent colors from Bunsen diagram. Bunsen diagram. This is, if red is absorbed, red is absorbed, blue green, I'm making it only green. Red is absorbed, generally green runs to the green and green, red are water, complementary. Green is absorbed, red is absorbed, green. Next, orange, blue. Next. Yellow, violet, yellow, green, yellow, violet, I'm ready. Yellow, violet, yellow. You remember the prominent colors. Red, green, orange, blue, yellow, violet. Like that to remember. This is what a Bunsen diagram is called. From all these complex colors, from all these combined colors, you can make it like red, green, and orange, blue or blue orange, and yellow, violet, violet, yellow. Right. One more point, right? Last point. The color properties due to charge transfer phenomenon are found to be dark. Are found to be dark. Dark. Because the charge transfer transitions are Lapote forbidden transitions. Forbidden means not allowed. Next point. The color properties due to D2D transitions are found to be light colors. Are found to be light colors. Light colors. Because these transitions are Lapote allowed transitions. Lapote allowed transitions. One of the questions. How the questions appear in the exam? Come on. Which of the following is colored? Which of the following is colored? Cu2 Cl2 Cd Cl2 Cu Cl Cu Cl. Come on, check all of you. Which of the following is colored?
CuCl.
Come on, what is the answer? Ah.
CuCl2, sir.
CuCl2.
Why is he not coming?
CuCl2.
CuCl2. Right, good. CuCl2. This is plus 1. Copper plus 1, not D10. This is Cd plus 2, D10. This is also Cu plus 1. 2 plus 2 plus. D10. Copper plus 2, D9. One unpaired electron, therefore color. Unpaired electron is their color. No unpaired electron, colorless. Come on, go on. Next. This is the question. The recent GBH. Next one. Whatever I'm writing on the board. The recent, also in 2019, this is the question. The GBH. In which of the following? Which of the following? The column property is due to. The column property is due to. DD transition. DD transition. DD transition. Think carefully.
K2MnO4.
Come on, what is the answer for this?
K2MnO4.
In which the color is due to DD transition.
K2MnO4, sir.
A or B or C or D, come on. You're not getting the voice because
B, sir. For B, sir.
Which one? Answer.
Sir, B.
What is the answer?
B, sir.
C. Here I am giving you plus 6. Mn plus 6 was this D1. Mn plus 6, D1. In this D0, this also D0. No, D constant. Charge constant. K2MnO4 D1. This is a question 2019 GBH. Next. Explain why MnO4 minus. You know this. HCO4 minus. ReO4 minus. This is purple. No. These are colorless.
Take it. Let's explain. Purple, colorless. Color same group. Still, this is exhibiting color, but these are not exhibiting color. All are D0s. In all these, we find compulsory charge transfer. But MnO4 is dark purple, but per technate, per lineate, colorless. Can you see why? In all these charge transfer, in this particular charge transfer, we see in the visible region. In these two, the charge transfer, we observe in UV region. The charge transfer transition, either absorption and emission taking place in UV region. Therefore, these two are colorless because UV absorbed or transmitted, that is colorless. Come on, right. For KMnO4, for MnO4 minus, the charge transfer, bands, we call. Charge transfer bands appear in visible region. But for TCO4 minus, REO4 minus, the charge transfer bands observed in UV region. Therefore, TCO4 minus, REO4 minus. Are found to be colorless. This is about color properties and which are appeared the questions in the recent last year and before last year in the questions. And next we have to start correlating properties. Next property we have to start. We will not time it up. Just one or two questions, right? Identify the number of unpaired electrons in the following. In the following, come on. 2 minutes time.
Please repeat the question, sir.
Come on, how many are here?
Five.
How many here?
Five.
How many here?
Four.
How many here?
One.
Like this, they give all the four and they ask you order of unpaired electrons are increasing order, decreasing order, like that they will ask you the question. So this you are wrong. So become perfect in this. So next we start tomorrow. The next property, athletic properties and all the properties.